Hi there, my name's Wayne Smith, and this week I'm reporting from a super special location. It's glitz, it's glamour, it's home to all the stars. You've guessed it, it's Hollywood. Talk to people basically on Carnaby Street today. There is Carnaby Street somewhere that you come and shop yourself?
Not particularly. I mean, occasionally American Apparel, just because, you know, the stuff's plain.
In the heart of our capital is found one of Britain's most famous streets to shop. It's filled to the brim with style and culture, dating back to the beginning of the last century. If you haven't already guessed it, it's London's Carnaby Street, home to many of the top fashion designers, from Tommy Hilfiger to Diesel. I'm in heaven. I've been told to come to this address for 5 o'clock. I'm running a little bit late. It's for a gig I've got tonight, so I'm a little bit nervous, a bit excited, but I'm gonna get in there and see what it's all about. Oh, this is a bloody wind-up. In fact, this plaque was placed here in dedication to one of the street's pioneers, John Stephen, who was responsible for bringing the mod revolution here to Carnaby Street. But what inspired such high culture and fashion here in this area of the capital? Well, in the 1960s, it was very popular among both the hippie and mod styles, with bands like the Small Faces, Beatles, and the Rolling Stones making regular appearances here to work, shop, and socialise. It's no wonder that this became one of the coolest destinations of the 1960s. Performing on Saturday night was the single most amazing experience of my life.
I think Wayne is such a good performer. Sometimes he can give himself a hard time because he doesn't know how good he is.
The judges are expecting a really, really big performance from us both, and we just have to deliver it. Okay, so how much are we looking to spend today, girls? So if you were out for a shopping day, how much would you look to spend, like if it was a complete day of shopping?
Depends, doesn't it? I think it really depends on where you're going and if you're going to get like a key item that you might be prepared to spend a bit more money on.
So is that the sort of first thing that gets sacrificed then, is when you're a bit short on cash, you need to stop buying clothes? Or
not really.
No?
If I see something that I like, then I don't mind being broke and getting it.
Well, fashion trends come and go, but good fashion taste stays with us forever. Although we're compelled to look our best all of the time, doesn't always mean we can afford it. So with recession and financial crisis all looming around the corner, we've come to the capital to see how people are still managing to look great, even in today's climate. I've been Wayne Smith. I hope you've enjoyed what you've seen today. Live from Hollywood, it's back to the studio.